In this video, we will be demonstrating the Osborne Reynolds Apparatus, the H215, which is part of TecQuipment's fluid mechanics range. It is a freestanding piece of equipment for demonstrating the transition between laminar and turbulent flow and allows students to investigate Reynolds numbers. Historically, many engineers and scientists investigated the behaviour of flowing pipes, but it was British physicist named Osborne Reynolds who first identified the variables controlling the flow and produced a rational means of predicting the nature of flow. Reynolds showed that the behaviour depends on the balance between inertia and viscous forces in the fluid. This led to the definition of a non-dimensional parameter, now called Reynolds number, which expresses the ratio of inertia to viscous forces and can be used to identify the conditions under which the flow changes from laminar to turbulent. By experiment, it was found that the change always occurred at a similar value of Reynolds number, irrespective of the fluid and the size of pipe. At a low velocity, flow tends to be dominated by laminar flow, which looks like a sheet of fluid moving smoothly. At a high velocity, the layers of fluid are mixed up and turbulence occurs. This will churn up the flow, known as turbulent flow. The Osborne Reynolds apparatus allows you to study the nature of the flow in a pipe by observing the behaviour of a filament of dye injected into the fluid. Let's take a look around the apparatus. As you can see, there is a precision bore glass pipe that is held vertically in a large stand that is open at the front with adjustable feet. At the top is a glass constant head tank. This holds water that passes into the main tube through this bell mouth entry here. The high quality glass composition allows optimum viewing of flow behaviours. The water to this tank passes through a diffuser and stilling bed which contains glass beads. These together create a uniform flow as the water passes through it. The fixed overflow pipe here ensures there's a constant head of water which should be connected with a tube to a drain. The thermometer included measures the temperature of the water, which is required for some of the experiments. At the rear of the apparatus is a supply pipe that can be connected directly to a tap or to the outlet of the optional temperature control module. For normal demonstrations, a controlled supply of cold water can be used. To find a flow rate, you collect a known quantity of water in a measured time. To see the pattern of flow, i.e. laminar, turbulent, and the in-between transition phase with intermittent pulses of turbulence in the pipe, you'll use a dye injector to inject a fine filament of dye into the top of the tube. The dye injector needs to be positioned as centrally as possible to get the best results. You can also use the optional heat module, the H215A, which is a separate freestanding unit for learning about the effect that the temperature of water has on its viscosity. For more information on the Osborne Reynolds apparatus and other experiments in the fluid mechanics range, including the friction losses and pipe experiment and viscosity and particle drag experiment, click on the link in the description box below. Thank you for watching.